Okay, so this method is called method of undetermined coefficients. Okay, so we'll go back to what we had written as our Taylor series expansions. We had written our Taylor series expansions for fxi plus 1, we had written our Taylor series expansion of for fxi minus 1, and then we could pick and choose which data points do we want to use in order to get the first differential or the second differential or higher order differentials of f. Okay, so I'll demonstrate that method. Again, we'll try to find f dash of x. So I will write our f dash of x as some a1 multiplied by f of x I minus 1 plus a2 multiplied by f of x I plus a3 multiplied by f of x I plus 1. Okay, so our undetermined coefficients are a1, a2 and a3. What we are trying to do is we are trying to get a 3-point difference formula for the first derivative f dash of x at the at x equal to xi. So we are trying to get a 3-point difference formula. Why a 3-point difference formula? Because we are going to use point xi minus 1, xi and xi plus 1 in order to get to derive that particular formula. Okay, so what is the 3-point difference formula for f dash of xi? 3-point difference formula for f dash of xi is nothing but the central difference. So what we expect is really our a1 over here. If we compare it to this particular equation, what we expect our a1 to be is minus 1 by 2 delta x, we expect our a2 to be equal to 0, and we expect our a3 over here to be equal to 1 plus 1 divided by 2 delta x. So we have 3 undetermined coefficients, so we require 3 equations, 3 linearly independent equations in order to obtain unique values of a1, a2 and a3. Okay, so we will substitute the Taylor series expansion over here, Taylor series expansion over here and the Taylor series expansion over here. So we can write down f dash of xi is going to be equal to a1 times f of xi minus 1, which is f of xi plus delta x, I am sorry, not plus, it should be minus. Minus delta times f dash of xi plus delta x square by 2 factorial f double dash of xi plus delta x cube by 3 or sorry again minus delta x cube by 3 factorial f triple dash of xi plus dot 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 plus a2 times f of xi plus a3 times f of xi plus delta x f dash, I will just use shorthand f dash of I plus delta x squared by 2 factorial f double dash of I plus delta x cubed by 3 factorial f triple dash of I. Okay. Now we will collect the terms in f, f dash, f double dash, f triple dash and so on and so forth. So what we will get is f of xi multiplied by a1 plus a2 plus a3. So fi multiplied by a1 plus a2 plus a3 plus f dash of xi multiplied by a1 multiplied by minus delta x, a2 multiplied by 0 because there is no f dash term over here, and a3 multiplied by plus delta x. okay, plus f double dash of I, and the terms in f double dash of I are going to be a1 multiplied by delta x square by 2. So, a1 delta x squared by 2 plus a2 multiplied by 0 plus a3 multiplied by delta x square by 2. Okay. And then we will have other terms, which is f triple dash of I, and there we will have minus a1 delta x cube by 6 plus a3 delta x cube by 6 and so on and so forth plus dot dot dot. Okay. So, now what we have on the right hand side we have and f dash of I term, on the left hand side we have terms in f dash fi, f dash of I, f double dash of I, so on and so forth. Okay. So, what we will do is we will identify each individual term with different colors, f dash of I, and we have this as f dash of I. So, what this means is that the coefficient of f dash of I is nothing but 1 multiplied by f dash of I, and that coefficient should be equal to this particular guy over here. Okay. So, we will equate that, we will equate the red box term in this part on the right hand side with the red number over here, all the other terms appearing should be equal to 0. Keep in mind that because we do not know a1, a2 and a3, we require 3 equations. So, the first equation is going to be a1 plus a2 plus a3 equal to 0. The second equation is going to be minus a1 delta x plus a3 delta x equal to 1, minus a1 plus a3 multiplied by delta x is going to be equal to 1, and the third equation is going to be a1 delta x squared by 2 plus a3 delta x squared by 2 equal to 0. So, a1 plus a3 multiplied by delta x squared by 2 equal to 0. That is going to be our third equation. Okay. So, based on this we will write a3 equal to minus a1. Based on this equation, substitute it over here. So, we will have 2a3 equal to 2a3 delta x is going to be equal to 1, or a3 is going to be equal to 1 by 2 delta x. Okay. Based on this equation, we will have a1 is going to be equal to minus 1 by 2 delta x, and a2 based on this particular equation is going to be minus of a1 plus a3, which will be 0 because a1 is minus 1 by 2 delta x and a3 is equal to 1 by 2 delta x. Okay. So, the value of a1 is this, value of a2 is 0, value of a3 is 1 by 2 delta x. Okay. So, that is the overall equation that we get using the method of undetermined coefficient. So, we substitute a1 over here, a2 over here, a3 over here, and this is the result that we will get. Essentially, it is going to be the central difference formula. Now, the question is, what about the error term? Okay. And the error term, to figure out what we have to do is substitute the value of a1, a2 and a3 in this particular term, the terms that we have neglected. Keep in mind that this has become 0, this term has become 0, this term has become 1. All the above, all these terms are actually non-zero, but we are neglecting it. Okay. So, error is going to be equal to minus a1 by 6 plus a3 by 6 multiplied by delta x cubed multiplied by f triple dash of xi, plus we have other terms as well. Now, if we substitute a1 and a3 in this particular equation and this term turns out to be 0, then we will have to look at the next term. If this term does not turn out to be 0, this becomes the leading error term and we stop our error analysis at this point. Okay. So let us substitute a1 equal to minus 1 by 2 delta x and a3 equal to 1 by 2 delta x. So error is going to be equal to minus 1 by 2 delta x multiplied by minus 1 by 6. So it is going to be 1 by 12 delta x plus 1 by 12 delta x multiplied by delta x cube f triple dash plus dot dot dot, and this becomes equal to 1 by 6 multiplied by delta x squared. This delta x and one of the delta x's over here will get cancelled multiplied by f triple dash. Okay. As a result of this, the error that we write over here is going to be equal to 1 by 6 delta x cube f triple dash of xi. Okay. So this is the error in central difference of f central difference f dash of xi. Okay. So this is the overall derivation using the method of undetermined coefficients.